And now take up item number 9, which was pulled by Councilmember Morrison. Councilmember?
Thank you, Mayor. Item number 9 is an item for us to move forward with building improvements for the Austin Regional Intelligence Center. And I wanted to take this opportunity. This is what's known as a fusion center, data fusion center. I know there were a lot of questions about that, and I wanted to take this opportunity to make sure we all understand what this is going to involve and what the timeline will be. So if I could get the city manager, I think perhaps the police chief might be the best person to help me understand and make sure that the public understands, because I've been getting a lot of questions about it, what this is going to involve. Good morning, Chief.
Good morning.
I wonder if you could give us an overview of what the center is and what it will be doing and perhaps the timeline.
Excellent. Thank you. Thank you, Mayor and Council, for this opportunity to talk to you this morning about the Austin Regional Intelligence Center. This is a center that has been in the works for the past almost 2 years. About a year and a half ago, we received a UASI designation in the greater Austin area, which is Urban Area Securities Initiative. With that came some funding specifically to deal with the threat of terrorism. Here in the Austin area, we are in the process of getting our regional center up and running. Our goal is to have it up and running by December. And what this center will be doing is it's an all crimes, all hazards approach to really sharing information with the agencies here in Central Texas, criminal data, to try to connect some dots in terms of emerging criminal threats and in terms of investigating and solving crimes. One of the things that we do very poorly here in this part of the state is that we do not do a very good job of sharing information to try to solve crimes, to try to bring justice to the victims of crimes. I wanted to ensure and reassure the council and the community and the stakeholders that we are going to be looking at best practices in terms of the privacy issues. One of the things that I've asked my staff to ensure and this group to ensure is that any type of document we prepare for distribution, any work product, has to go through the executive committee. The chair of that committee will be Assistant Chief David Carter, who's our chief of staff, and is very well versed on what we have, I think, as a standard here in terms of privacy. Some of the highlights are that some of the agencies that are going to be participating is the Austin Police Department, Hays County, Travis County, Williamson County, Georgetown Police Department, Round Rock, Pflugerville, San Marcos, because we have an all-hazards approach. In other words, pandemic flu-type issues. We also have Austin, Travis County Health Department, EMS, and fire to be part of this center. The center will be operating in compliance with the Department of Justice regulations contained in Title 28 of the Code of Federal Regulations. I want the council really to know and the public that we are going to adopt very strict privacy guidelines that have already been written at the national level with conjunction with the National ACLU, the American Civil Liberties Union, and we will be sharing those policies and discussing it with the council so you can have the opportunity to review it before we ever go operational. And also, I know that John Bush is here from the Texans for Accountable Government. We have been communicating probably for the past year. I don't know where John's at. I know he's in here somewhere. And our commitment to him and to the ACLU and other stakeholders is that they will have the opportunity to review our privacy, our policies, our procedures, our MOUs before we go operational.
Okay, and do you have an idea of when we might expect those to be available for review?
I would anticipate hopefully by the end of this month we should have all the policies ready for review. And again, our target date is in December. One of the exciting things for me about this, what you're voting on today, is the fact that we're leveraging resources, and by sharing that space, the $200,000 is paid for out of the grant, the federal grant, to do the build out on the workspace, and basically the lease is, I believe, about $1 a year with the Department of Public Safety, which is something we always talk about, is partnerships to try to do more with less.
Okay, and another question I have is, one of the items of interest is always exactly what data is going to be part of this. Is there going to be a listing out of all the databases that
it
will
is
be?
Going, it will be primarily, it has to, it's going to be arrest reports, incident reports. There has to be a criminal predicate in order for it to be in the system as part of our privacy policies. We can only maintain the data for 3 years and only if necessary. I think what's really important for our community to know that the Austin Police Department has really taken the lead in this endeavor. We understand the sensitivities of our community, and the other agencies that are going to participate will have to be part of playing and operating under the rules and guidelines set by the Operating Council, which includes also our mayor's part of that task force as well.
So, for instance, we have... we'll soon have online a automated license plate reader. I take it that won't be automatically tied into this database
No.
then, since that's not predicated on criminal activity.
There has to be some predicated to specific criminal activity or reasonable suspicion of criminal activity.
Okay, and then one other question that's arisen. Do we already have a fusion center somewhere in Central Texas, or is this going to be the first one?
Well, the state has a fusion center for the state. Quite frankly, we haven't really done anything with them in the past. I've been here for 2 years, and I think with the new leadership, with the new colonel, we're going to see a lot more cooperative efforts in terms of crime fighting here in Texas, and we do not have one here in Central Texas. This will be about the 73rd regional intelligence center in the nation. We are well aware of some of the mistakes that have been made in the past in other fusion centers, and I can assure you that, and you will see with our, as we roll out our policies and procedures, we will not make those same mistakes, because our ultimate goal is not to be Big Brother. Our ultimate goal is to focus on crime prevention. If we see any emerging threats in terms of criminal threats, and is crime prevention, and really to connect some dots and hopefully solve some crimes.
Thank you, and I'm sure almost everybody, if not everybody, shares that goal with you in terms of crime prevention, and I appreciate your sensitivity to making to the community's concerns, making sure we go into this transparently, and working to not repeat mistakes that have been done before.
Absolutely, that's our commitment.
So I'll move approval.
Well, I'd just like to say at first that, as the chief mentioned, I'm part of the urban area working group, which met last week and includes officials from the 5-county area, and the vote to recommend this action was unanimous by that group. So before you make your motion, council member, we do have 14 people signed up to speak.
Mayor?
Mayor Pro Tem.
Thanks. Chief, I wanted to thank you for the briefings that you and Chief Carter came and discussed with me and the information you shared. And while the questions and concerns I may have had have been relieved, what I'd like to ask as we move forward is that, as I noticed the mayor and the city manager and yourself and the fire chief and EMS director and OEM staff are all city folks that are on this, but if a year and a half ago you guys started meeting and you knew you were going to receive money and move towards this fusion center, I would have hoped that we could have been able to alleviate some of these concerns and have these conversations way in advance of this week. And so moving forward, what I would ask is that when policy considerations are being made, that the council, the full council, stays briefed on it so that we can hopefully avoid some of this in the future.
Absolutely, and my apologies for that, but just so you know, we have had ongoing discussions with some of the stakeholders, and as we finalize the final draft from our point of view on the different policies, we will roll those out to the council, to the mayor and council, and to our stakeholders as well.
And Mayor Pro Tem, as chair of the Urban Area Working Group, I'll give you my assurance we'll do the same thing. However, we don't meet again until next January. So,
thank you very much.
Thank you, Chief. And we do have speakers, so you might want to hang around. All the speakers are signed up against. The first speaker is Laura Martin, and she has a donation of time from Danielle Nasser. Is Danielle in the room? Danielle, thank you.